Hi students, welcome to my channel Doctor's Physics, and this is the first video on doubt clarification section. And the first doubt is asked by the Saran, and he asked me, what is the difference between Fleming's left hand rule and right hand rule? Where we have to use Fleming's left hand rule and where we have to use Fleming's right hand rule? Now see here, Fleming's right hand rule and Fleming's left hand rule. I will use Fleming's right hand rule in the chapter EMI, that means electromagnetic induction chapter, where I will use the Fleming's left hand rule in the chapter moving charges, that means magnetic field chapter. Now I will use the Fleming's right hand rule to find the direction of induced current. And I will use the Fleming's left hand rule to find the direction of force acting on the current carrying conductor. See, I will use the Fleming's right hand rule to find the direction of the induced current. And I will use the Fleming's left hand rule to find the direction of force acting on the current carrying conductor. Now see here, the thumb, the middle finger and the forefinger. The thumb is used in Fleming's right hand rule. The thumb is used to say me the direction of velocity. And the middle finger will give me the direction of induced current, and the forefinger will give me the direction of magnetic field. Same in Fleming's left hand rule, the same thing. The thumb, the magnetic field, and the forefinger. The forefinger will give me the magnetic field, direction of magnetic field. The middle finger will give me the direction of current, and the thumb will give me the direction of force. See, in both the cases, the forefinger is magnetic field, the middle finger is induced current and current, and the only thumb is changing. Here thumb is velocity, here the thumb is force. Now see here, a current carrying conductor, simple wire, and it is placed in the magnetic field. What is the direction of magnetic field? Now what is symbol? This is into symbol. Into means into the paper. That means the magnetic field is in this direction. There are two symbols, into and dot. Into means nothing but into the paper. That I will assume the magnetic field is into the paper. Dot means opposite. That means if into is into the paper, dot means outside the paper. Now the magnetic field direction is inwards. And now the velocity of the rod is in this direction. This is the velocity direction. Now they told to find the direction of induced current. Now what I have to do? If they told to find the direction of induced current, I would use Fleming's right hand rule. Now the thumb will give me the velocity. If a velocity, the thumb is giving me the velocity, and the forefinger will give me the magnetic field direction. The magnetic field direction is into, and the middle finger will give me the induced current. Therefore, induced current direction is upwards. Okay, now we'll take one more. This is a wire, and this placed in the magnetic field, and the velocity is in this direction. Now see here, the magnetic field is represented by dot. What is the meaning of dot? Into means into the paper, dot means outside the paper. The magnetic field in this is like this, outside the paper, towards you. Okay, now what is the direction of velocity? In this direction. Now you use the Fleming's right hand rule to find induced current. Thumb will give me the direction of velocity. Okay, where this forefinger will give me the direction of magnetic field. And that means like this. This is the velocity direction, and this is the magnetic field direction. For direction of induced current is downwards. See here, this is the direction of middle finger will give me the direction of induced current. Therefore, induced current is downwards. Therefore, this is induced current direction. Now you see for Fleming's left hand rule, this is the wire. In this wire, the current direction is like this, and the magnetic field is like this. Now they told to find the direction of force acting on this wire. Now I have to use Fleming's left hand rule. When I am using Fleming's left hand rule, what I have to do? The middle finger will give me the direction of current. That means direction of current. And the magnetic field is given by four finger. That means magnetic field is which side direction? Into means into the curve. Therefore, magnetic field is like this. Magnetic field direction, current direction, what is the direction of force? The direction of force is given by the thumb. That is showing me this side. Therefore, this is the direction of force. And if you take one more example, now using this is the example, wire. And the current carrying is in this direction, current is in this direction, and the magnetic field is in this direction. Magnetic field means dot. Now see, dot means the magnetic field is outwards, and current direction is this. Now use the Fleming's left hand rule. Middle thumb will give me the direction of force, then my forefinger will give me the direction of magnetic field. Magnetic field is outwards, and this forefinger will give me the direction of current. Direction of current is in this direction, like this. Direction of current, magnetic field direction. What is the direction of force? Direction of force is like this. Therefore, this is the direction of force. This is Fleming's right hand rule and Fleming's left hand rule. I think this is clear by now. And if you guys have any doubt, it may be any topic, please mention in my mail. Within 24 hours, the doubts will be clarified. Thank you.